Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It is your girl Dutchy, and today I am bringing you some of the best LGBT TV shows on Netflix in 2018. LGBTQ+ representation is on the rise, and these days we've even got some LGBT characters staying alive for more than a season. I mean, that is an achievement in itself. So the following TV shows that I mention are, in my opinion, the best LGBT TV shows on Netflix at the moment in 2018. Before I get into the video, it would mean the absolute world to me if you could subscribe to the channel, become part of the Dutchy fam, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy watching Netflix too. Now let's head on into the video. Okay, now this first one, everything sucks. Oh my god, I binged watched this entire show from start to finish in one day, one sitting. Didn't have a toilet break, didn't have a snack break, no intermissions, just watched it, sat there and watched it. I was so engrossed by this TV show, honestly, loved it, and that's why it's number one, because everything about it, I love. Everything Sucks is an American comedy drama created by Ben York James, and it basically just parodies teen culture of the mid-1990s. And there's only 10 half-hour episodes, which is exactly why I was able to binge watch it in one sitting. Far out, what a day that was. And it basically just portrays some teenagers in the 1990s who are making a movie themselves, actually. And it basically just shows the teens dealing with issues such as finding their sexualities, mental health issues, and growing up. So a really good stock standard TV show, absolutely love it, with gay characters in it. Highly recommend. Let's be honest, I highly recommend all of these shows, but that's definitely my fave. And Everything Sucks definitely did not suck. Next up, we've got Orange is the New Black. I'm guessing most of you have seen that, at least one episode of it. Most people have. Girl on girl, actiony, dramery, jail cell-y, you know what I mean? Really good, lots of drama. Haven't seen all of it. I've seen the first three seasons, I think. But again, it's just a good one to always go back to, so easy to watch. And it's also packed with a lot of twists and turns. Definitely not boring, and very, very LGBT friendly, which I love. Queer Eye for the Straight Guy. Honestly, this is so underrated. I love watching Queer Eye. Again, a really easy TV show to watch and to get into. Every episode's different. I just love how sassy they all are, and I actually love the transformations. I love seeing them turn guys into something else, you know what I mean? And make them look good. Just the power of the queer eye, you know what I mean? No, honestly, Queer Eye for the Straight Guy is so freaking good. I'm so glad they brought that back and popped that on Netflix, because it's a winner. It's an absolute winner. You, Me, Her. I've only seen a little bit of this, but I've read lots of reviews and I know all about it. I just haven't gotten around to watching the rest of it. I should really do that. So You, Me, Her is a bit of a rom-com. It basically just follows a married couple that want to delve into polyamory and a polyamorous relationship with another woman. Saucy. I actually really like this show. It was funny without being immature, and I liked how they found a really good balance of comedy and, like, you know, like relatable real life stuff. I think it showed a really good insight into what life would be in a polyamorous relationship, like with another partner. One of the things I loved the most was that each of the episodes is only half an hour long, again, so really easy to binge. And yeah, no, I really liked You, Me, Her. Up next is Sense8. Now, Sense8 is seriously wild. Unlike any other show I have ever seen, but I love it. It is so different. Now, my favorite part about this is that the actual creators of Sense8 have come forward and said that every single character in Sense8 is actually pansexual. Two of the main characters, Lito and Hernando, portray a really healthy relationship between two men. And the best part about this show is that Naomi Marks, a transgender character, is played by a transgender actress, Jamie Clayton. So an actual transgender human playing a transgender character. Mind-blowing, amazing. Yes, we need more transgender representation, if you ask me. Now, unfortunately, this show was stopped after two seasons. I don't know why. It was awesome, and it represents the LGBTQ+ community in a really great way. One that I haven't seen, but so many people have spoken about, is Wynonna Earp. Now, I've been told to watch this TV show by so many people because it portrays heaps of powerful female characters. I've just watched a couple of review videos so I could fill you guys in, because I haven't seen it, I will be honest, but I think I'm about to. So from what I've heard, it's very quick, very witty, very funny, and the characters in the show have really in-depth storylines. Like, it's not just base level. The L Word! So The L Word is a series that basically features a group of lesbians and bisexuals. So basically it's just a drama filled, action packed, sex packed, relationship packed, you know, like drama, just drama, drama, drama of these lesbians and bisexuals that live in LA. And honestly, it is easy to watch again. The L Word is a banger. very, very good. So those are the TV shows that I thought I'd go into detail with. The next couple deserve a bit of an honourable mention, but they're not like some of the best ones, but they definitely have LGBT characters in them that are cool too. The 100 and Vampire Diaries both have LGBT romances in them. I loved Vampire Diaries. Seriously, I cried on the last episode. If you're a Vampire Diaries lover, comment down below and let me know. But honestly, far out, I cried. There are definitely LGBT characters and storylines within both The 100 and Vampire Diaries. Another one that I haven't seen, which one of my housemates watches and she's obsessed with it, is Wentworth. Now, I haven't seen Wentworth. I want to know what you guys think of Wentworth. If you've watched it, let me know in the comments below. Should I watch it? Should I not? I don't know. So yeah, those are some of my fave LGBT TV shows on Netflix in 2018. I hope some of those suggestions helped, and maybe you can go and binge watch some now if you hadn't heard of them or you hadn't seen them. So yeah, those are my top 10, 20, I don't know how many I did, picks for best LGBT TV shows on Netflix in 2018. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!